So you only heard part of the story so far. And now on Times Now is the real story that the army was made to back off. Veena Sikri, former diplomat. Alka Acharya, former member of the National Security Advisory Board. General Sani, former deputy chief of the army staff. My first question is to General Bakshi. You think this has been a mistake? You heard the news report there. You think this is a big mistake we've done by making the army back off when we actually had, for the first time, a strategic advantage. To give up that advantage, do you think this is a huge strategic defeat actually for India?
It certainly is, you know, Arnab. And, you know, it is tragic how there is a feeling of deja vu. You know, history repeats itself. The first time as tragedy, the second time as farce. If you see the build-up of events, it is exactly how it happened before 62. All that we would like to state is a lot of water has flown in the Indus between now and 1962. It is not the same Indian army. And may I also state very clearly, the Chinese army also hasn't been in a fight in the last 32 years. The last time they fought was in Vietnam and they did not come out with flying colors. So the fact of the matter is, I don't think the Chinese army can get away with a lot of hot air. Things may be quite different on the ground. The pity is that when they could have been different, the army has been absolutely put on a leash.
And it's been put on a leash by the it's been put on a leash by a group of diplomats and bureaucrats comprising this China study group. You know, that really is the story.
Absolutely.
Has this been too pliant a posture? Veena Sikri, you know, the India has been vehemently arguing on record that we have not conceded to any Chinese demand. The foreign minister says there are no deals in international levels. We do not do deals at this level. But this sounds pretty much like a deal. Is this deal in India's strategic interest?
I would make three points here. First of all, the strategic defeat that you talk about. I think the interest that you're referring to in this strategic defeat is the question of India wanting to develop its infrastructure in the Eastern Ladakh sector, at Daulat Beg Oldi and other airports in this sector. I think that is crucial and that should not be stopped, and India should in no case agree to stop.
But we have already
infrastructure
have
development.
No, no, but we already have.
Totally.
But we already have, Ms. Sikri, because as this report said, for the first time in decades, the Indian army was learning from China's strategy of military dominance. And it actually, the Indian army for the first time began hectic troop movement around the border to be vigilant and aggressive in posture. This was a result of the several Chinese intrusions through air, land and sea in the past. When the Indian army gives it back to China in that eye-to-eye standoff, the China study group comprising of the National Security Advisor, bureaucrats of the MEA, MOD and MHA say the Indian army is going overboard, it is disrespecting the border agreement with China and it forces the Indian army to back off. That's what has happened.
No, I think, the China study group must take on board the views of the Indian army. Because
that's
it's the responsibility of the Indian army to protect our territorial sovereignty. And if you want them to do the task well, they must give you the feedback on how they can do it well. And if you don't take on board their feedback, then the task will not be done well. So I do think that the army must be represented in some way and as directly as possible on the China study group. And perhaps it is lacunae that it does not happen. Now, aggression. The Indian army has never engaged in aggression. The Indian army's task is to take a firm position in protecting the Indian borders. So talking about the Indian army's aggression is a sine qua non, because Indian army does not have any instructions to be aggressive.
True.
So in this situation,
true,
when the Chinese have taken the aggressive posture, when
yes,
they have come into India's territory, then it is a task of the Indian army to
then
stop
what
it
kind
as
of
soon
diplomacy
as possible
is
on
this?
Day one and day two if possible.
No, no, what kind of candy
give
floss?
Give them the operational independence.
What
give
kind
them
of
the
candy,
operational
candy
independence
floss
to do so.
What kind of candy floss diplomacy is this? Because what the Indian army wanted was a robust positioning of troops. It simply wanted a robust positioning of troops. I don't know tomorrow, you know, if there is something called the India Study Group, Alka Acharya, in China, because when they, you know, have such a massive ramping up of their strategic interests and are brazen about it, they don't have an India Study Group in Beijing. which would immediately make the PLA back off if the situation were to be reversed. Has this been a mistake, Alka Acharya?
I have never been in accord with this line of argument that unless you are yelling from the rooftops or taking strident positions or aggressively marching towards what you feel is some sort of a problem, that you are actually doing the wisest thing. What we are looking at today is a diffusion of a crisis that was building up, and that there is now an inevitable period when positions will be examined, the whole scenario will be gone over. You are, obviously, your channel is so well informed, you know exactly what went on in the rooms.
Miss Acharya, we spoke to the Indian Army. We spoke to everyone.
You must
no, one second. One second. We've spoken to all sides. And you know what they said? Ms. Acharya, you know what they said? They said we have been told to be quiet about this.
I would like to know.
Yes.
Look, Mr. Goswami, I would like to know that if the army is taking a position, why is it not being stated officially?
Because they have been asked to be quiet about it. Because obviously the army would obviously go with whatever the civilian leadership decides. Now, obviously, in this position, nobody is being aggressive. Nobody is being aggressive. But what the Indian army is doing is robust positioning. The Chinese get irritated by it. And then the bureaucrats and diplomats tell the army, please back off.
It is rather unfortunate that you are giving a cast of craven kind of yielding to a very substantial process of dialogue that has gone on. The Chinese tents have been taken off from there. I don't see how, and how can you say that the army will quietly tell people, oh, we are being told to be quiet? I mean, this goes beyond the bounds of the system that we are in which the political process takes control of the military process necessarily. You cannot have a system whereby the army is going to sort of move on and say, we will go on the aggression, but we've been told to be quiet.
I'll ask General Sani this. The question, obviously, is this, that when China has shown such utter disregard of its commitments across the border, why are we so cautious and concerned that there should be no breach to the point to which we tell our army to back off at a time when they wanted to have a more robust positioning of troops? And you can try and keep quiet about it, but the fact
but
of the matter is this.
You have sorted out the problem.
As Veena Sikri says, you must involve the army point of view more aggressively. The problem has been sorted out possibly at
a
cost.
How do you know that?
General Sani, what do you think?
How can we say it has not been?
It has been sorted out at a price.
Say,
yes, General Sani.
Arnab, I would say, Arnab, I am not privy to what happened in the China study group and standoff between the army and the MEA or the political bosses. But I want to tell you that this is a very sensitive area. And here we require to develop our infrastructure to the same level as the Chinese. It is required to prepare our armed forces much more than what it is being done at the moment. And now also we have to ensure that we continue to patrol the area up to what we perceive is our border. And if such situations arise, which have arisen today, then we should not be blinking. And there should be a system put in place where there is a joint consultation and the armed forces are given the due, what do you call, regard as far as their view is concerned. And I would also like to point out that this is an active border. In this active border, to have ITBP and acting under the
ridiculous
MHA itself is an aberration.
Absolutely.
I think it's a terrible aberration. And it should be completely put under the operational control, because if such a thing happens again, we should not be found wanting, I would say. And I would again put a point, Arnab, that in all the army commands, in the combined commands in the American army, armed forces, they have the Foreign Service officer attached to the headquarters. So why is it that in the Indian context they don't have a foreign officer, foreign service officer attached to the northern command or to the southern command, where they can render advice to the commander. Why should everybody jump into the such situation, crisis situation, when it arrives and cause confusion? Why can't we learn from this particular episode and be better prepared for future?
Well, I mean, as the report has pointed out, there was a cold war of sorts on the one side between the MEA and the NSA, and on the army on the other. At that point of time, you know, the army chief was called in and a compromise was struck. Alka Acharya says, what is the big deal about this compromise? This is the way things are, and you know, Alka Acharya, you're playing it down tremendously.
No, Mr. Goswami, please, you are no. I am not playing it down, Mr. Goswami.
You are not.
Really sorry that you should be putting a very different construction on what I said.
Well,
I did not say a compromise.
You're all right with what has happened.
Agreement was reached.
Agreement
to diffuse. No. Wait a bit. To diffuse a crisis that was building up.
Yes.
Now, we have to now proceed to see what led to it. We have already, and I have made
what
this
led
point
to
over
it is clear.
Channel,
no, what led to it is clear. What led to it? What led to it? No, what led to it? I'll ask you. What led to it, Alka Acharya, was troop movement, force expansion, laying of tracks and fortifications by the Indian Army near the LAC, which the Indian Army thought was the right thing to do. The China study group felt that was the wrong thing to do. They said this is the Indian Army going overboard. General Bakshi, was it the wrong thing to do? If building infrastructure is in our interest, then how can the Chinese object every time that we build infrastructure? And if we have agreed to what they have said, is that not a strategic retreat?
Arnab, the Chinese, took that period of peace and tranquility, which was, negotiated in the aftermath of the Sumdurangchu incident, the Wandung incident in 1986-87. It used that period of peace and tranquility to construct a railway line till Lhasa, where 8 railway trains come every day today. And these are standard gauge railway lines, broader than our broad gauge. They can bring up to 32 divisions in the space of a mere 1 month into the Tibet, autonomous region. 58,000 kilometers
of blacktop road. What are we talking about? Really? I mean, what are we talking about here?
No, one second. General Bakshi, Alka Acharya wants to counter you. One second. Alka Acharya wants to counter you. Let her.
No,
she feels you're going on the wrong track. Let her. She says, what are we talking about? Yes, why do you... One minute. Alka Acharya, why do you feel he's going... General's not on the right track? Please come in. I'll come back to the general after that.
No, I didn't say that. I said... Yeah, I didn't say he's going on. I said, what are we talking about here? We are talking about a problem that emerged in mid-April, which both countries decided to talk and settle and at least resolve the crisis, immediate crisis. Now we are bringing in issues. I mean,
we were told they unilaterally withdrew.
No.
We are talking. No, the point that was mentioned just now about infrastructure building. Why have we not really focused on infrastructure building? No. See. This is the whole point. You have this problem of lack of infrastructure in the Northeast. Now that is another issue. The issue today is that the agreement that the two sides reached to resolve a crisis and not let it go out of hand was, I think, a very wise and the right thing to do.
No, what's
and
it?
Now let's examine how do we settle the problem.
No. This is where I'd like to
why
come
the
in
crisis.
Jal Bakshi.
I would like to come in, please.
Yeah, Jal Bakshi, please counter.
Madam, the genesis, Alka, of this intrusion lies in the Chinese desire to stop and put an end to our infrastructure construction on the Himalayan border because it is worrying them. Now, the fact of the matter is they have utilized the period of peace and tranquility to complete their infrastructure construction, and by the help of this intrusion are now trying to force upon us a modified border agreement.
What stopped
where
us?
Such infrastructure?
No, because every time we build the infrastructure, we now set the precedent.
Additional troops will not be allowed to come to the border.
One minute. Veena Sikri.
I have one point to make here.
Veena Sikri.
I have a My point that I would like to make here is that we have to examine why this problem started when it did. Alka is talking only about the diffusion of the problem, which is the end of the problem. But why did it start in middle of April on the eve of the Chinese Prime Minister's first visit outside, coming to India? And I think this is the point to analyze, not how it ended, but why it started. The Chinese have known for some time about our interest in developing infrastructure in East Asia. But why did they come in now? They wanted to test India and have been failed that test. And have been
saying
they've come 19 kilometers into our territory, and we are talking about diffusing a situation which you allowed to go on for 20 days without any action by the Indian side.
No, excuse me.
Obviously, the army will feel frustrated because it is their job to protect the border.
No.
Don't allow them to do that, then it raises a big question on their credibility and their motivation
to
protect the border in other sectors. I think the whole question about operational independence, with control from the Ministry of Defence is very important.
My answer was to the question that Mr. Goswami put up. Of course, the point was first to diffuse and now to examine why it happened. Mr. Goswami began by asking, do you think this is a craven kind of a surrender and why was the army not? I was answering that. I am not saying that we should not go into why it happened or why did it happen at that particular juncture. I mean, either
but why
we
can't
sort
we take the army's
question,
point of view on board?
It, and
what
then
is
go
wrong
on?
In taking the army's point of view on
of
board?
Course,
in
and,
China,
and
we
I
know
said,
the role that the army plays
sure, this is,
in decision-making structures.
Sure, Mr. Sikri,
and the
but
army could
I am
not
have
come 19 kilometers.
I am
India
not privy
without
to
their own political and military leadership knowing about it. So if they know about it, why can't our army play its own role in putting its point of view forward? There's nothing wrong with that. Ultimately, it's a decision of the government, of the political leadership, the government of the country, and that will remain. But we have to analyze, and we have an open debate in our country, unlike the Chinese media, which is very closed. So if there are points of view being expressed, I think they need to be discussed and taken on board.
Because the Chinese do not act
like this without a certain purpose. I think we are all very clear on that. And we need to understand what their purpose was on the eve of their Prime Minister's visit.
Yeah, Ms. Achal.
No, I am saying that I am not privy to what happened in the back rooms or inside the offices and so on. I mean, we did notice the army chief going and meeting the Kashmir chief minister. We noticed him going and briefing. I mean, what is there to assume that the army's views were not taken on board?
Well, I mean,
these are all conjectures. As I said,
why is there no
official position? I mean,
we
you
don't
can
conjecture.
Go and get these scoops,
no, we
but
don't
it
conjecture.
Does not make me, as a scholar, I find, no, no, no I don't
we
find
don't
it,
conjecture.
I find it very difficult to
Wait,
accept
we don't,
so
we don't,
and so
we
said,
don't,
so
we
and
don't,
so reported.
No, we don't,
but this is not an academic.
Miss Acharya, let me assure you, Times Now is not known for conjecturing at all. But Times Now is certainly not going to be complicit in keeping the truth away from the people of this country. And Miss Acharya, I want to place one fact. I did not use the word. On a lighter note, Miss Acharya, I did not use the word craven. You repeated the word craven thrice. I simply said that the result was a standoff was a result of hectic troop movement, force expansion, laying of tracks and fortifications. I did say that the Indian Army wanted to do that. I followed it up by saying that the China study group felt that the Indian Army was going overboard. I did not use the word craven, but if you think it was craven, I will not dispute that. That's your, just perhaps your point of view,
I
not
don't,
mine.
I don't. It was.
That's on a lighter note. That's on a lighter note.
That's.
We can agree to disagree. We can agree to disagree. General Sani, from your experience.
Okay.
General Sani, 1 minute. General Bakshi, let me go to General Sani, please. General Sani.
I wanted to.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah, I like to tell you, Arnab, I like to tell you, I have commanded my corps on the Indo-Tibetan border. And I think we are miles behind as far as infrastructure is concerned. We must aggressively made our infrastructure. We must prepare ourselves because Chinese are known for their assertive and I would say the bullying type of tactics they use. And if you don't blink your eyes in front of them, that would be the only redeeming thing to do. If you continue to surrender to their whims, no, we shall be then going into a groove which may prove costly. I don't know really what happened.
General Sani,
I would like to tell you that we should take a lesson from this particular episode.
I mean,
we are creating infrastructure.
Why don't we see,
where,
First of all, the Chinese are pretty clear about what they want.
I'm not saying surrender. I'm saying
the Chinese say that even when the Chinese Prime Minister is here in India, he says Arunachal Pradesh is part
and
of China.
They continue to.
The Chinese are very clear.
Even when the Prime Minister
is in India, he says Arunachal Pradesh is part of China. My question is very different, General Sani.
They always up the ante.
Miss Achar, my worry.
The lesson to be drawn from this situation is that we hope that in the forthcoming visit of our foreign minister to China and the forthcoming visit of the Chinese Prime Minister to India, that this issue will be taken up and clarified thoroughly once and for all.
So
because that's the only lesson we can draw.
Ms. Sikri, my point of concern is this.
There should be clarity on the ground from all sides as to what is the actual line of actual control, where the army is, and we should talk to the Chinese.
My point of concern is this. We've always been talking about this. Why now? If I were to just analyze it this way, if you just give me a minute, maybe the thing escalated now because the Chinese realized that the Indians cannot, have a standoff with us before our premier comes to Delhi. And hence, the Indians have been trying to get into a slightly stronger position. General Sani, I want you to answer this, that the Indians have been trying to get into a slightly stronger position for some time now, because our Premier is coming to Delhi. The Indians will not want to create a situation, and hence, this is the best time to squeeze the Indians. And in that case, General Sani, maybe they succeeded. Maybe they succeeded pretty well. That is the only thing which explains the timing.
I agree with you. You see, because the curious time. Yeah, that you see, the point is you are absolutely right. This curious time, I would say they chose this, what they thought was a perfect opportunity. And actually, that is the time we should have actually not blinked. And ultimately, in the end of the day, you are absolutely right. They get a message that if they use such bullying tactics, probably they'll get their way.
That's worrying because we need to build our infrastructure. We can't give in to them every time.
That's not what is important.
General Bakshi.
We can't give in.
General Bakshi, wanted to come.
The aspect of timing that you have raised,
I don't know where we are going with the analysis of this whole issue.
Last year, excuse me please, can I just have my say?
Yes, Ms. Acharya, let General Bakshi
complete. The Chinese had raised the issue of revising the border agreement and trying to stop any additional infrastructure and additional Indian troops from coming up to the border. Now, this goes against all that we have been trying to achieve to counter the Chinese moves. The Chinese intrusion just before the visit of their prime minister was designed to bring this center stage, to force us to talk on this and possibly back down on this issue.
Yeah.
And if we do so, please understand that we would be freezing in perpetuity our military and infrastructural disadvantage on the Himalayan front. I don't think any self-respecting government or self-respecting people will understand. I hope we are also factoring in the emotions of the people of Ladakh, which are inflamed, which feel let down, and they feel that they are marginalized to the larger Indian consciousness. Let's please think of the people of Ladakh who are being deprived of their pasture grounds. It is not just a localized intrusion. It is not just a piece of land where not a blade of grass grows. We have heard those excuses before 1962.
Well, General Bakshi, while we can be emotional about it, I think the only practical answer for India is to raise our defense infrastructure and our military infrastructure and our presence and our roads in that area to a point where we don't just counter, but we are better than China. I think the people of this country can afford that, and maybe that is the best defense required. Just giving in is no answer, but you don't have the strength. You're going to have to give in. So build the strength, rapidly build the strength, and then talk Turkey with the Chinese. Maybe that's the lesson. Even Alka Acharya will welcome that.
No, we have to continue to build strength and negotiate from a point of view of strength.
Of strength,
because
yes.
Negotiations are give and take.
Yeah.
But you have to negotiate from a position of strength.
Alka Acharya also.
Strength,
Alka Acharya, you also support that, I presume.
Develop our infrastructure everywhere.
I don't think there would be any disagreement on the issue of building your own defenses and your own strengths to be able to protect your boundaries. I am saying over and over again here that we have, of course, counter it if required, but the point is that we first need a settled border. And there is always going to be this problem of incursions, intrusions.
No.
And unless we recognize that there is a dispute and that we have to move towards settling it, your strengths and all notwithstanding, you are going to have these over and over again.
But dialogue, to my mind, is the way out. Outstare the Chinese and outbuild the Chinese.
From strengthening yourself.
Outstare and outbuild the Chinese in military terms. Maybe that's the lesson. Well, we put the story out. I'm surprised the details of what have been going on have not come out, but maybe a lot of people have been told to remain silent about it. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.